Thank you, President. Prime Minister, first of all, allow me to congratulate you to your first presidency. Wish you the very best. I'm sure you can do very well. I hope you will do better than the Czechs in 2009. You can do 7 years better than we have done. So wholeheartedly, I do support the Slovak presidency. For quite a few years, we've been hearing in this hemicycle from different prime ministers and presidents, we are at the crossroads. We are in a dramatic situation, complicated. We heard some strong words. We heard we need reforms. You have deviated to some extent from that, and I do appreciate it. Also because we are not any longer at the crossroad. We have left the crossroad, and we came to a political dead end. And we need to break that end. And that, I think, is something that we should recognize. Slovakia, for me, as a member of the European Union, is a success story. I mean, you have managed to steer in the last 12 years the country from an average country, averagely developed, to a real success story, much more than that. And I think that this is something that we need to recognize and applaud. I was going to ask you to remind, also based on that story, what were the founding values and reasons of the European communities. You have done that, and I do appreciate that. And let's have the courage to remind ourselves and remind our nations, our people, what is really the story. What is history? What is the future? And of course, what are the bottlenecks and the problems that we see? So if you have managed to steer the country from an average situation, so to say, and I know that a few days ago you said you fear high expectations. Well, I will not comfort you. I will not reassure you. We have high expectations. We have the expectations that you will manage to steer the European Union out of crisis, and that is something that needs to be done, not because of us MEPs, not because, in fact, of our vague dreams, but because of the citizens that are tired of the European Union as it stands today. Now, we have heard from the Council numerous comments in the recent days, blaming, shaming, and I think that this is exactly the worst messages that we can get, and I'm glad that it would not continue on that path, because the European institutions as such, jointly, as you have said, have to tackle the challenges which are in front of us. Now, we have a choice of the European Union of tomorrow. It can either be a European Union with all the success, and I do agree with you that it's a marvelous and unique project, but with all the deficiencies that we have, incapable of delivering, or we can deliver on issues like crisis, the real bottlenecks, the issues that concern the citizens, migration crisis. You have spoken about the internal market, etc., etc. This is, I think, the European Union that we want. This is the choice that we should choose. I would say two final remarks. We speak of reforms, and we met many years ago, first time in my office, and I knew that you are a person that can deliver. Two ideas. One is, why not open the deliberations of the European Council to the public? Sometimes even the Prime Minister do not know what has been agreed the day before. Make it transparent. Provide for confidence. The second is, why not have a program of a revision of the secondary key? Deal away with all the issues that we should not be focusing on, but let's tackle the big issues, the ones that there is an added European value. You have our support, and we hope that we will jointly succeed, and all the best once again. Thank you.